If we have a quantum particle moving freely through space, its wave function may look as shown. On the other hand, if we have a quantum particle trapped inside a box, its wave function may look as shown. Why do the wave functions look so different in the two cases? To answer this question, let us consider a wave function where the amplitude is the same everywhere throughout all of space. Because the amplitude is the same everywhere, we have no knowledge of the particle's position. But we know the momentum with 100% certainty, and this momentum is determined by the wavelength. A particle with a larger momentum is described by a wave function with a shorter wavelength. The wave function we saw at the beginning of this video is actually a superposition of several different wave functions with different wavelengths. The larger the number of wave functions of different wavelengths we add together, the larger the peak in amplitude will be in one particular location, which gives us more knowledge about the probability of the particle's position. But this also causes us to have less knowledge of the particle's momentum, because the particle now has a probability of being measured with the momentum associated with each of the various wavelengths. Let's now consider the case of a particle with a known energy trapped inside a box. Here, there is uncertainty if the momentum is moving to the right or if the momentum is moving to the left. A particle with a known momentum moving to the right has a wave function that looks like this blue spiral. A particle with a known momentum moving to the right has a wave function that looks like this blue spiral. A particle with a known momentum moving to the left has a wave function that looks like this orange spiral. Since we don't know if the momentum is to the left or to the right, the total wave function for the particle is the sum of the blue spiral and the orange spiral. The sum of the two spirals is shown here in green. This gives us the wave function for the trapped particle, which looks like a flat, rotating sine wave. This satisfies the boundary condition that the amplitude of the wave function must be close to zero at the boundary of the box. Whereas a quantum particle traveling freely through space can have any wavelength, trapped quantum particles can only have wavelengths where the amplitude is close to zero at the boundary of the box. In this video, we've only discussed the case of a single particle. Things get much more exciting when we have multiple identical particles trapped together. And this is discussed in the video, What Causes the Pauli Exclusion Principle? Please subscribe for notifications when new videos are ready. And if you're able to, please consider supporting us on Patreon through the link in the video description. Thank you.